For years, he's been among the most outspoken journalists in India, a reporter for whom telling the story, the complete truth, comes first, always and at any cost. Today, at a time when free speech and independent thinking are disappearing in India, NDTV's Ravish Kumar and his family face hate, insult and repeated, often daily, death threats. Despite the trauma, he continues, and NDTV backs him, we always will. Tonight on Left, Right and Center, who are the people wanting to kill Ravish Kumar? What is the nature of the threat? How often is he threatened? This program is not just a look at the blatant hate that targets one of India's most critically acclaimed journalists, and you will see what we mean by that, but also to highlight the shrinking space journalists have in our country. That's one of our goals on this program. It's a space that is shrinking daily given the widespread nature of the threats. Who are these people? Are they random online trolls or something far more sinister? What you will see will shock you.
अप्रैल का आखिरी हफ्ता था, अचानक मेरे फोन पर हजारों नंबर से हमला जैसा हो गया। ये हमला ही था, क्योंकि 10 दिनों तक 24 घंटे फोन आते रहे, रात के 2 बजे भी और दिन के 3 बजे भी। एक नंबर ब्लॉक करता तो 10 और नंबरों से फोन आ जाते। एक-एक सेकंड के अंतर पर कई-कई फोन आए। स्पेन, रोमानिया, लातविया, मलेशिया जैसे मुल्कों के नंबरों से फोन आने लगे। सबकी भाषा एक सी, सबकी धमकियां और गालियां एक सी। व्हाट्सएप खोलना मुश्किल हो रहा था। जब खोलो मेरी माँ को, पत्नी को और बेटियों को गालियां और धमकियां देखने को मिलती थीं। मुझे हिंदू विरोधी कहा गया, पाकिस्तान का समर्थक कहा गया। मैं उस दौरान तेज बुखार से पीड़ित था। समझ नहीं आया कि ऐसा क्या हुआ है कि फोन पर इस तरह का हमला हो गया। तभी ऑल्ट न्यूज़ के प्रतीक सिन्हा ने एक लिंक भेजा कि मेरे नाम से एक बयान वायरल किया जा रहा है, जो मैंने कहा ही नहीं था। यही वो फेक मैसेज है जिसमें कहा गया है कि दिल्ली में मदरसे में गीता के साथ हुए कथित बलात्कार के मामले में मैंने बलात्कार का समर्थन किया है, जो मैं कर ही नहीं सकता। बदनाम करने का तरीका पहले भी रहा है, मगर इस तरह सामने आकर गाली देने, धमकी देने या मार देने की इनकी हिम्मत बताती है कि ये सत्ता को लेकर ज्यादा ही सहज हो गए हैं। इन्हें भरोसा हो गया है कि जो करना है कर चलो, एक भीड़ है, अपनी सरकार है जो हमारा कुछ नहीं बिगाड़ेगी। ये तस्वीर मुझे बार बार भेजी गई कि इसी तरह मुझे काट दिया जाएगा। आईसीस आतंकवादी संगठन ने जिस तरह पत्रकार डेनियल पर्ल को मारा, उसकी जगह मेरा चेहरा लगाकर दिखाया जा रहा था। एक ने वीडियो भेजा कि ठीक से देख लो, इसी तरह काट दिया जाऊंगा। हमारे सहयोगी ने एक ऐसे ही मैसेज के बाद फोन कर दिया। मारने की धमकी देने वाले देवेंद्र फौजी को जब बताया गया कि उसके साथ हो रही बातचीत रिकॉर्ड की जा रही है, तब भी वो बोलता रहा कि दफ्तर आकर गोली मार देगा।
ये भाई मैंने नंबर उसमें मिल गया, मैंने फेसबुक से आया मेरे पास।
हाँ जी बोलो।
हाँ भाई, आप वो रविश कुमार जी को गाली दे रहे थे?
हाँ दे रहा था।
क्यों भाई, क्या बात हुई?
उसको, वो देश का गद्दार है, उसको गाली नहीं, उसको गोली मारूं।
अच्छा, गोली मारेंगे? कहाँ से आप?
अरे तू कहाँ से बोल रही है बताना।
मैं दिल्ली से बोल रहा हूँ, एनडीटीवी में हूँ। और
हाँ फिर एनडीटीवी में क्या छड़ देश के किस करो तुम? आप यहाँ सुन, मैं एक फौजी हूँ, बात सुन।
हाँ कॉल रिकॉर्ड हो रहा है आपका, आप आओ यहाँ पर अर्चना कॉम्प्लेक्स एनडीटीवी का ऑफिस, आओ यहाँ पर, मैं मिलना चाहता हूँ आपसे।
ठीक, नाम क्या अपना, शुभ नाम?
मेरा नाम करमवीर सिंह छिकारा है।
ठीक है।
हाँ हाँ, नहीं फौजी कहाँ पर, आपकी पोस्टिंग कहाँ पर है बताओ ना, कौन से नकली फौजी हो, असली फौजी हो? नकली हो तुम फौजी।
मैं तेरा बाप हूँ।
हाँ हाँ, वो तो मुझे पता है कि कौन किसका बाप है। हाँ हाँ, मुझे ये बताओ तुम कहाँ पर हो, कौन सी फौज में हो तुम?
मैं तेरा बाप।
देश के पाकिस्तान फौज में, इंडिया की फौज में तुम? हाँ तुम हो कहाँ पर, आना यहाँ पे अर्चना कॉम्प्लेक्स है एनडीटीवी का ऑफिस, आओ किसी दिन तुमसे मुलाकात की जाएगी। और तुम अभी
दिन मुलाकात तुमसे हुई ना, उस दिन सीधे पैरों से तुम जाओगे नहीं।
अच्छा,
ये बात दिमाग बैठा लेना।
अच्छा जी, ऐसी बात है क्या?
हाँ ऐसी बात है।
हाँ हाँ, आपका कॉल रिकॉर्ड हो रहा है, एक पहली बात तो मैं ये बताना चाह रहा
हूँ। करो ना, जनता बहुत नहीं है, ठीक है?
अच्छा, करो रिकॉर्ड। नहीं, इस तरह से आपको किसने सिखाया ये ऐसी भाषा शैली?
ये भाषा देशभक्ति सिखाती, देशभक्ति,
देशभक्ति,
ठीक है? तुम्हारे जैसे नमक हराम देश में पड़े ना, उन्हीं जैसे चोरी।
अच्छा अच्छा अच्छा,
एक बात बताओ, तुम ये बताओ हिंदू या मुसलमान, पहले ये बताओ।
नहीं नहीं, हम हिंदू है। नहीं 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 नहीं, अरे हम भारतीय हैं।
देश के गद्दार हो,
अच्छा
पब्लिक को बना रहे हो हैं।
हाँ, क्या किया, एक लाइन बताओ कि क्या किया ऐसा जो तुमको इतना हर्ट किया, बताओ।
सर जो उल्टी बातें तुम्हारा, और क्या रविश कुमार कल उसको ये पता नहीं जिस देश में रह रहा है उसकी कट्टी कर रहा हो।
हमने इसकी जानकारी जमा की, फेसबुक प्रोफाइल से पता चला कि ये CISF में काम कर चुका है, अब नहीं करता है, मगर तस्वीरें बताती हैं कि इसे हथियार चलाने की ट्रेनिंग मिली है और दिमाग में हिंदुत्व का जहर भर दिया गया है। जाहिर है इसे हल्के में नहीं लिया जा सकता था। हमारे सहयोगी ने CISF से पता किया तो उन्होंने भी कहा कि अब उनके साथ नहीं। अब यही लड़का शाम को दोबारा फोन करता है, माफी मांगने लगता है और एक वीडियो भेजता है जिसमें गोली मारने वाली बात पर माफी नहीं मांगता बल्कि फेसबुक के कमेंट के जवाब में गाली देने पर माफी मांगता है।
अभी कुछ दिन पहले फेसबुक पे मैंने रवीश जी जो NDTV में पत्रकार हैं उनकी पोस्ट पे कुछ लूज टॉकिंग यूज की थी, जोश में आके होश खोने वाली बात थी। उनकी कुछ बातें मेरे को अच्छी नहीं लगी, मेरे को लगा कि यार शायद ये ठीक नहीं है, तो मैं तेज में आके मैंने उनको गाली दे दी थी जो मैं मुझे नहीं देनी चाहिए थी। एक जिम्मेदार नागरिक होने के नाते ये शब्द यूज नहीं करने चाहिए थे, तो मैं रवीश जी से माफ़ी मांगता हूँ इसके लिए कि मुझसे गलती हुई है, और मैं मुझे दुख है कि मैंने भद्दी लैंग्वेज में उनसे बात की।
अभिषेक तिवारी खुद को जौनपुर का बताता है, बजरंग दल के छात्र यूनिट का जिला अध्यक्ष है, साफ साफ लिखता है कि मुझे गोली मार देगा या मेरे बारे में ऐसी जानकारी लिखता है जिससे मैं भी हैरान हूं कि उस तक ये बात कैसे पहुंची। क्या ये किसी योजना पर काम कर रहा है? इसने एक लेटर पैड भी भेजा साबित करने के लिए कि बजरंग दल से ही जुड़ा है। फिर एक दिन वीडियो भेजता है जिसे आप सुनिए, उसके दिमाग में भरे हुए जहर का असर देखिए।
उस सुवर रवीश कुमार को मैं चेतावनी देता हूं, अगर इसी तरह तू सनातन धर्म को बदनाम करता है तो एक दिन मेरे हाथों से मरेगा तू। दौड़ा दौड़ा के मारूंगा, यहां से पाकिस्तान लेके जाऊंगा जहां तुम्हारा घर है। इस बार बजरंग दल की ये चेतावनी है रवीश कुमार सुन तू, अगर अगली बार ऐसा हुआ दौड़ा दौड़ा के मारूंगा तुम्हें, फिर कोई बचाने वाला तुझे मिलेगा नहीं।
गाली देने वाले अब गुमनाम लोग नहीं है, इनकी ID फेक भी नहीं है। इससे पहले भी धर्मो रक्षति रक्षिता ग्रुप ने मुझे कुछ महीने पहले धमकियां दी थी, व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप में जोड़कर मेरे जिंदा होने पर अफसोस जता रहे थे। इनमें से कई लोग दावा करते हैं उन्हें प्रधानमंत्री फॉलो करते हैं, मोदी सरकार के मंत्री फॉलो करते हैं। आप इन तस्वीरों को देख सकते हैं, मेरा नंबर जिस तरह के पेज से पब्लिक किया जाता है उन पर भाजपा 2019 नमो फॉर 2019 लिखा होता है। और ये रहा शिकायतों का पुलिंदा, गालियों की प्रिंट आउट दिल्ली पुलिस के पास जमा है, FIR भी, मगर ये फाइल जितनी मोटी है उससे कहीं ज्यादा ये लोग अलग अलग शहरों में तैयार कर दिए गए जो धर्म के नाम पर आपके साथ कुछ भी कर जाने का दुस्साहस रखते हैं।
रवीश जॉइंस मी नाउ इन द स्टूडियो, as does Swati Chaturvedi, the journalist and author, Rana Ayub, another journalist who has been abused, who's been threatened, joins us as well from Mumbai, Ejaz Ilmi of the BJP with us, Pratik Sinha, the founder of Alt News, and Vikas Singh, the senior advocate of the Supreme Court. Ravish, when did the death threat start coming?
ये 25-26 अप्रैल के बाद की बात है। मैं ऑफिस नहीं आ रहा था और अचानक मेरे फोन पे हजारों फोन आने लगे, हजारों नंबर, एक ब्लॉक करता दूसरा नंबर आ जाता, तीसरा नंबर आ जाता, और सबकी भाषा मतलब इतनी खराब है और सब एक खास तरह के विचारधारा के लोगों से, विचारधारा से इंस्पायर्ड लोग हैं और उससे इतना मोटिवेटेड हो गए हैं, जहरीले मतलब कह सकते हैं, और इतना डेयरिंग कि वो खुल के मारने की, कुछ फोन तो मैं रिकॉर्ड नहीं कर सकता, मेरा आईफोन है, लेकिन जब बाद में हमने सेटअप किया और उसको बजरंग दल वाले को आपने देखा तो इस तरह से वो खुल के बात कर रहे थे कि आपको खींच के मार देंगे, और 15-20 मिनट तक वो गालियां देते रहते थे, लगातार गालियां देते रहे, और मैं पहले ये समझता था विष्णु कि इन सब चीजों को ध्यान नहीं देना चाहिए, मैं देता भी नहीं हूं, कोई फर्क भी नहीं पड़ता मुझे, लेकिन बताना जरूरी है अपने दर्शकों को और जो मुझे पढ़ते हैं कि ये एक ऑर्गेनाइज्ड है और इसमें कोई शक नहीं है कि चूंकि ये मेन पॉलिटिकल पार्टी से अलग हटके, अभी कशिश न्यूज पटना में एक चैनल है, उसके संतोष जी ने भी इसी के कॉन्टेक्स्ट में इन्वेस्टिगेशन किया था, तो हिंदू नाम से, हिंदू संगठन, गौ रक्षा संगठन, सनातन संगठन के नाम से वहां 80 से ज्यादा संगठन बन गए हैं और सबको जिलाध्यक्ष बना दिया गया, कुछ कुछ बना दिया गया है, और ये लोग एनोनिमस ट्रोल नहीं है। हमें अब ये समझना पड़ेगा कि इन सब को एक पोजीशन दी गई है जिलों में, अलग अलग जगहों पे कोई कमलेश तिवारी का बनाता है, सो अब आप इसको इग्नोर नहीं कर सकते हैं, ये कहीं भी लिंच मॉब की तरह आपके आसपास जमा हो सकते हैं, इस तरह से खुलकर बात कर रहे हैं,
and they send you WhatsApp messages identifying themselves,
जानते हुए भी कि ये लीगली सबूत हो सकता है, वीडियो बना के भेज रहे हैं, तो इनको ये हिम्मत कहां से आ रही है? पहले तो ऐसा नहीं होता था, हम पहले भी लोगों के खिलाफ स्टोरी करते थे, आज के बाद भी करेंगे और आज की रात भी करेंगे, है ना? जो मंत्री पुशअप कर रहे हैं उनका बताऊंगा कि पुशअप करने से क्या होता
नहीं,
है, काम नहीं करने
what
से क्या होता
पुलीस,
है।
व्हाट हैज द पुलिस टोल्ड यू, यू फाइल्ड एन FIR, इज इट पॉसिबल फॉर द पुलिस?
मैंने पहले भी किया था, उसमें कुछ नहीं हुआ, इस बार मैं गया तो पुलिस रिसेप्टिव थी, उन्होंने कहा आप दीजिए और हम इसका असेसमेंट करते हैं। FIR मेरे शिकायत को उन्होंने FIR में कन्वर्ट किया है और आज ही बता रहे हैं कि हम सिक्योरिटी असेसमेंट कर रहे हैं, पर वो चिंता की बात नहीं है कि मेरी सिक्योरिटी से ज्यादा कि ये एक पॉलिटिकल कल्चर जो बाय प्रोडक्ट तैयार हुआ है विष्णु, हम अभी भी इसकी सीरियसली नहीं ले रहे हैं, सोच रहे हैं एक इंडिविजुअल की समस्या है, ये लगातार शहर दर शहर वायलेंस को इंस्टिगेट कर रही है और किसी को घेर कर धमका रही है, किसी को मार रही है, कोई फीमेल जर्नलिस्ट है वो लोग ज्यादा जानती है कि उनके साथ क्या हो रहा है, जो मेल है वो कोई नहीं बचा है इनके दायरे से, और इन सब को फंडिंग है, इन सब के पास एम्यूनिशन है, इन सब के पास वेपन भी है, वेपन आप कह सकते हैं कि इनको यही लोग डुअल रोल प्ले करते हैं,
कि
जब रामनवमी का जुलूस होता है तो उसमें तलवार लेके निकलते हैं, फिर फोन लेके आपको सनातन, मैंने क्या सनातन धर्म का किया है?
रविश वर्मा
क्या बिगाड़ लिया है?
विकास सिंह कम इन एट दिस स्टेज, the threats he faces are not one or two, there are literally hundreds of threats,
thousands,
there are thousands of
thousands.
threats over a period of years, in fact over the last few months
it's gone
up much
more. Vishnu, agar aapke phone pe agar aapke phone pe agar main agar din mein 24 ghante agar is tarah ke phone aate rahe aur main block karta rahu aur aap ek message tak type nahi kar sake, ye ek naya skill hai attack karne ka, ki aapka number le lo aur unko lagatar raat ke 2:30 baje sawa baje
Ravish, one moment Vikas Singh, in a situation like this when one individual, one journalist is threatened in this manner by thousands of calls, messages, WhatsApps, SMSs, what can the law do to protect him?
Well, he should register FIRs against each one of them, and in fact
he's done that,
multiple
he's
calls
done that
made,
but the point
numbers,
I'm making, sir, is that the numbers are outstanding. One FIR against one group of people, there are more which keep coming back. It's an army, they, you know, it's from not just India, some of these numbers are from around the world, blatant WhatsApp messages. How does anyone get to the bottom?
Everyone is getting political patronage.
And people who are willing to identify themselves, people who are willing not to identify themselves, how does a police force track so many people?
Well, if it is ultimately found to be an organized effort, then there will be somebody found to be behind the whole thing, and that person the police will have to get to that person basically, because the way Ravish Kumar has just narrated, it doesn't look as if these are random people who have decided to call him. It looks like, you know, these are all people who are part of some group and they have all decided to do it, you know, simultaneously. That is why when he blocks one number, he gets a call from another number. So this pattern is continuing. So even if there is a person situated outside the country, even he can be booked in the Indian courts, and FIR can be registered even against him. And if he's of Indian origin or if he's having an Indian passport, then the case can be taken up against him as well.
Okay.
And the ones which are, you know, death threats, etc., people who are, you know, making those are very serious offences. And those would be non-bailable, and those police will definitely have to register cases. And ultimately, it's a question of a law taking its own course. But the real problem, the core issue, is actually the intolerance that is growing in the youth of today. that they are not ready to listen to any view which is not palatable to their mind. So they feel that whatever is in their mind, whatever they feel is correct, that is the only view which should be expressed.
Mr. Singh, just one moment.
Anybody trying to give a
I couldn't agree more. Nobody wants to listen. They just want to abuse and threaten. No one cares about it. Rana Ayub is no stranger to facing death threats. But what has happened to her in the recent past, when there is a video of hers, which a pornographic video with a morphed face appearing on it, meant to shame her, meant to be distributed and distributed, stills taken off it. Rana, again, can you give us the scale at which these attacks are taking place? It's not one person. I think that's the point we're trying to establish here.
Absolutely, Vishnu. It's been happening with me for the last 8 years. I mean, when it first started in 2010, the Mumbai police offered me a license of a revolver in response to my complaint. That's about it. And they took no cognizance of it. And it's been happening over a period of for the last 8 years. The last 3 weeks have been a living hell for me. I mean, a lot of people say that, you know, women journalists are brave. I refuse to be brave. I crumbled. And I have no embarrassment in acknowledging that. There were thousands of people who were sharing screenshots of a pornographic video with my image mobbed in it. That image was sent across to everybody. It was circulating in the right-wing ecosystem. People were sending me those images with their naked bodies, asking me for my services, asking me for my rates. My number, my address was put on social media. A fake tweet was generated and put on social media that I endorse child rapists in the name of Islam. And that led to 1,000 people, including a Yogi Adityanath fan page called Yogi Adityanath Ki Sena, translating the fake tweet into Hindi and generating 4,000 retweets, and every tweet asking and invoking others to reach my place and gang rape me. My address was put on social media, my image, my phone number was put on social media. Clearly these are not trolls, it's a syndicate. A troll will not have my number. It's a syndicate which is working overtime. These are people, yes. this is a lynch mob. This is a lynch mob which is being provoked to attack us when they see us in public. The other day I was standing at the airport at the immigration queue, and an elderly gentleman was standing in front of me, turned around, just literally came to my face and said, you know, women like you need to be thrown out of the country. You don't even know who's the next person who's going to slap you.
Yeah.
I mean, I have not seen anything worse than this. And to see that these people who are abusing me, who are threatening me, gang rape, are being followed by union ministers of state like Piyush Goyal and Narendra Modi and Anu and so on and so forth. This is endorsement from the state.
Okay. Swati, you have written extensively about troll armies. How is this organized by political forces? How is this being done deliberately to target certain groups in our society, journalists not least of all?
Vishnu, first of all, I want to make a couple of basic points. This is not some youth who's not willing to listen. These are people who are paid to attack. This is the party in power, the ruling party, attacking, forget us journalists, they are attacking citizens who have another view, and we are still a democracy. These people are paid. They work in call centers of hate. They have hate lists of people like me, you, Ravish, Rana, Rajdeep, anyone who even remotely disagrees with the Modi Sarkar. They are called to Mr. Modi's house, they are patted on the back, they have pictures, they write, blessed to be followed by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. They are followed by union ministers. They exult when a woman journalist is shot dead. They say things like, you know, I can't use that word on air, her puppies are crying. Now, when all this is happening, this is state-sponsored, you know, vendetta by the party in power against journalists, and I have documented it. I have enough proof in my book, I'm a Troll Inside the BJP Secret Army, which proves that this is all funded. This is not some misguided random trolls. These are all people who are paid to do this, to attack media.
Swati, I want to go back to Ravish in a moment, but before I do that, I want to play out this threat that he received. It's one among several, but just look at how blatant and how brazen this is.
अगर इसी तरह तू सनातन धर्म को बदनाम करता है तो एक दिन मेरे हाथों से मरेगा तू. दौड़ा दौड़ा के मारूंगा, यहां से पाकिस्तान लेके जाऊंगा जहां तुम्हारा घर. इस बार बजरंग दल की ये चेतावनी है रवीश कुमार, सुन तू. अगर अगली बार ऐसा हुआ, दौड़ा दौड़ा के मारूंगा तुम्हें. फिर कोई बचाने वाला तुझे मिलेगा नहीं.
One sec, I just want to go back to Ravish. Ravish, you have a child, you're married. How does this affect not just you, how does it affect the people who love you the most?
आसपास के लोग काफी परेशान हैं, खासकर इस दौर के बाद कि मुझे कुछ ज्यादा सतर्कता, केयरफुल रहना चाहिए, मुझे ध्यान रखना चाहिए. मेरे जो मुझे दर्शक हैं मेरे, वो बहुत चिंतित हैं कि मैं अपने लिए क्या कर रहा हूँ. और शायद उन्हीं का दबाव था कि मैं पुलिस में गया, वरना ये इनका तरीका है कि आप थाना थाना घूमते रहें और वकीलों की फौज खड़ा कर देंगे, वो एक और दूसरा मसला है. और होना जाना कुछ नहीं है स्वाति, अभी ठीक का कुछ नहीं होना है इन सब को. विष्णु, इतना आसान नहीं है कि आप एक टीवी जर्नलिस्ट को या फिर किसी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी के स्पोक्स पर्सन को, किसी फीमेल टीवी जर्नलिस्ट को आप वीडियो बनाकर देंगे, दौड़ा दौड़ा कर पाकिस्तान तक घुसकर मारेंगे. मतलब आप इस, ये आ कहां से रहा है? ये आप सोचिए ना, ये लगातार पॉलिटिकल फीडिंग हो रही है इस तरह से शहर से कि एंटी मोदी है, एंटी इंडिया है, एंटी हिंदू है. जैसे मोदी होना ही भगवान होना हो गया इस देश में, उसके अलावा तो आप कुछ हो नहीं सकते देश में. तो अगर आप उसके अलावा कुछ हैं तो आप एंटी हिंदू हो गए, आप एंटी इंडिया हो गए, और आप एंटी प्रो मुस्लिम हो गए या प्रो पाकिस्तान हो गए. हमें तो नहीं मालूम है कि इस देश में तो एक रॉ के चीफ और आप पाकिस्तान के आईएसआई के चीफ मिलकर किताब लिख रहे हैं, और हमें ये जनाब कह रहे हैं कि हम गोली मार दौड़ाकर मारेंगे. तो चिंता की बात है विष्णु, ये साधारण बात नहीं है. ये पूरी दुनिया में ये हेट और ऑर्गेनाइज हेट की चर्चा हो रही है. फेसबुक से लेकर गूगल तक की अकाउंटेबिलिटी की चर्चा हो रही है. सिर्फ हमारे देश में कहा जा रहा है कि आप इसकी चिंता मत करो, ये कोई फ्रिंज है. अगर आप ये समझते हैं फ्रिंज है
विष्णु,
एक्सक्यूज है, और आप रियलिटी से बहुत दूर हैं. ये फ्रिंज नहीं है, ये ऑर्गेनाइज्ड मेनस्ट्रीम पार्क्ड इन एवरी स्ट्रीट एंड कॉर्नर इन दिस कंट्री. ये आप समझिए, जो किसी मोमेंट पे आपके खिलाफ इस तरह से फायर लेकर आ जाएंगे कि आपने मुसलमानों के बारे में ऐसा बोला है, आप एंटी हिंदू हैं, और आपको हम घर जलाएंगे या आपको मार देंगे. अभी उत्तराखंड में क्या हुआ, अगर वो एसआई गगनदीप सिंह नहीं होता तो एक लड़के को लोग मार चुके होते इस वक्त.
वन सेक रविश, लेट्स गो अक्रॉस टू एजाज इल्मी. मिस्टर इल्मी, द फैक्ट ऑफ द मैटर इज दिस, इट्स नॉट अ सरप्राइज टू एनीबॉडी, इट्स ओल्ड न्यूज दैट अ लॉट ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स सब्सक्राइब to the Twitter handles of a lot of people who blatantly abuse. What can the government do? Why has the government done precious little to protect the freedoms of journalists? And don't tell us that, you know, journalism and all is all free, we worship the true values of journalism in this country. We know that is not true. Look at the attacks taking place. These are only two journalists over here who have been attacked in this manner. There are so many.
You know, coming from a media background myself, being a former journalist, I can say with very comprehensively that whether it's Ravish Kumar or whether it's Rana Ayub or any journalist, you can voice your opinion. It can be contrary to the view of the ruling party or any other government in a different state, but you have the right to do so because you're doing your job. And if you're threatened for that, and it's threatened to kill for that, then obviously the government of the day has to provide that security and be accountable and assess the threat.
But the point being made, it is those who are. There are those who are working essentially for the government or parts of the government who are threatening. That's the point. Anybody has written a book on this.
Anybody working for the government on government salaries and
that's a technicality. Whether you are earning from the government or you are part of an institution that endorses the government and are willy-nilly being told that you will endorse a particular line, and if that line is challenged, then you will attack that person. Come what may, then you are working for the institution.
Every political
whether
party,
it is the party, government, it's all synonymous.
You can challenge every political party, every government. That's the job of a journalist. If somebody disagrees with it, then obviously you are entitled to have your own safety and security, and the government is entitled to providing that to you. And this threat assessment must be carried out by every government wherever a journalist faces threat. In regional, in a lot of states where journalists are killed because of fight against contractors or against mafia or against government officials, obviously
why do so many
people
MPs
are getting killed?
Why do so many government leaders continue to subscribe to the Twitter handles of people who spread hate?
Well, it's very, very clear that it starts off. How this entire thing works is something that I can't fathom. But all of us can be victims of this this malicious hate. I would call it a hate crime.
No, but Ajaz, that's no answer.
इसको इतना simplify मत कीजिए. ये समस्या बड़ी हो गई है. ये समस्या एक दिन आपकी पार्टी के नेताओं के दरवाजे तक भी पहुंच जाएगी. इसलिए आप इतना इसको सिंपलीफाई मत कीजिए.
मिनिस्टर्स ऑफ दिस गवर्नमेंट हैव आल्सो बीन ट्रोल्ड.
आपकी पार्टी से जुड़े हुए
मिनिस्टर्स ऑफ दिस गवर्नमेंट आर नॉट थ्रेटन्ड.
इस तरह के लोगों को
नॉट थ्रेटन्ड विद डेथ. देयर फैमिली मेंबर्स आर नॉट थ्रेटन्ड विद रेप.
People
don't come up to their faces and
such
push them aside.
Should be fought, identified and
आपके नेताओं के साथ होता तो आपके नेता तीन घंटे तक भाषण देते और तमाशा बना देते कि उनकी माँ के साथ ऐसा हुआ.
And can I come in here?
Okay, just one second. One moment, Ravish.
उम्र में उनके बलात्कार की धमकी वो भी आपकी पार्टी के पेज के नाम से लेकर देंगे और आप इस तरह से बहाना बना रहे हैं कि हम बोल सकते हैं जैसे आप इजाजत दे रहे हैं कि आपने कोई चीज
भी एज अ पार्टी के नॉट बी पार्टी टू समथिंग लाइक दिस.
यही इंटरप्ट कर रहा हूं आपको समझना है. आई एम सॉरी.
वन मिनट वन सेकंड.
क्या किया है कि आपने बीजेपी को अलग कर दिया है और नए नए संगठनों में इन लड़कों को पार्क किया हुआ है.
रविश वन सेकंड. रविश लेट हिम आंसर. आई वांट टू गो अक्रॉस टू प्रतीक ऑल्सो. जस्ट क्विकली आंसर मिस्टर इल्मी बिफोर आई गो अक्रॉस टू प्रतीक. गो अहेड.
No, I'm very clear that if these hate crimes, this malicious propaganda, this demonization, vilification, death threats, rape threats, I mean, there's not something that to be proud of in a democracy. And the police establishment in every state, whether it's Delhi or otherwise, has to come on very strongly. And all such groups or individuals who are trying to perpetuate this hate culture in this country, we need to fight it together as individuals, as political parties, as a group of journalists. We need to fight it together as citizens. But on the same side, no party can draw sustenance from something like
all
this.
All right. Okay. All right. Prateek Sinha, as the founder of Alt News, as somebody who fact checks and busts a lot of rubbish which is circulated in the name of truth, can you tell us how widespread is this business of fake news? Because fake news is essentially linked with these attacks that you see. If you have a different perspective, then that perspective is not accepted. It is called fake news. And these people who actually give the truth but are called fake news people, these are the people who are attacked. How widespread is this institution of targeting people as fake news journalists or people who spread fake news?
Before I go to the fake news issue, I just want to make three points. Number one, when Gauri Lankesh was murdered, multiple people celebrated that murder, and people whom PM himself follows. The explanation that BJP IT cell head Amit Malviya gave was that PM cannot unfollow these people because he respects their freedom of expression. That was the most absurd explanation. Because of exhibition, that person can still say whatever he or she wants to say on Twitter, and then Twitter can act according to its own policy. So the party actively supported all these people who celebrated the murder of a journalist and did not made sure that the PM does not unfollow all these hate mongers. Number two, recently on Lok Sabha TV, a journalist was hired and she had openly called for genocide in Kashmir. She had celebrated the massacre of Sikhs in 1984, and this person was given a job in Lok Sabha TV. Number three, if you look at the recent tweet by Mr. Modi himself, you know, forget everybody else, but Mr. Modi, sort of giving out greetings on Ramzan, and you should just see the amount of hate that the PM himself had to face because of that. You know, as a PM, he greeted a community of the country, a religious community, and the amount of hate that the PM had to see, that shows the amount of hatred that has seeped, especially into the right wing, the part of the politics that represents the right wing. Regarding fake news, the issue is that, for example, recently we had debunked a fake news where it was being claimed that Mr. Ravish Kumar had said that, you know, the 11-year-old girl Geeta who was raped, he endorses it because it was consensual, and which is why he endorses it. And now because of that, the screenshots are circulated on WhatsApp, on Facebook, they are shared thousands and thousands of times, and it becomes reality. I mean, even if you talk about it that, this is fake, we wrote a story on it, but that got shared like 7,000 times, but the screenshot itself is shared 10,000 of times, and that becomes the reality And that has become a serious issue. What Rana faced recently, that was even more extreme, you know, that pornographic clip that was circulated, plus that tweet from a parody handle, which was circulated not just in English, but in different languages. And I know the kind of hate she faced. So this has gone to levels which are completely extreme. Yes, fake news has become a major facilitator in forming people's opinions, in polarizing people's opinions, and which has led to this increase in hate.
No, it's what's outrageous is that even as this program goes on, you know, there are people who tweet, who are tweeting, and they're spreading hate. So it's this system which is designed to spread hate constantly. Any reaction, for example, I'm told most, this was a little while back, in fact, most of so-called death threats to journals are concocted for self-promotion and tricking the government to get police protection for free of charge.
It's absurd.
I barely tweet, I don't. And I'm being told all of these. Why? Because I picked a subject which irritates, which angers.
Vishnu, can I just make two points here quickly? You know, I totally endorse what Prateek said, but the fact that Mr. Modi is followed by millions of people, he chooses the people he follows. He actually unfollowed a woman who'd complained about a BJP spokesman. So it's not as if he's upholding some great freedom of, you know, speech. And the other thing is that one person who was like my assigned troll has just got the dubious honor of being followed by Mr. Modi for the way that I'm targeted. I get death threats, rape threats on a daily basis from this person, and he now, it's an anonymous profile, is being followed by Mr. Modi. So this is clearly a reward system at play. That great, we are watching you, you're doing a great job, so here is the ultimate endorsement.
Rana, how do you deal with this? Because it's been going on, as you said, for 8 years. How do you deal with it? How does your family support you, knowing that, you know, I mean, you're being targeted. Literally, you're being targeted.
You know, at least Ravish is at least fortunate in one way that he has NDTV backing him. I have been an independent journalist for the last 5 years now. And for me to get a lawyer, to have a legal system back me, to have absolutely no organizational backing. Yesterday, the UN rapporteurs, five UN rapporteurs in an extraordinary move, issued a statement for the first time. They do not issue statements in individual cases, but they did because the situation had become so grave and there has been a pattern of attacks on journalists in India. What happened to me? I mean, I would not wish that on any human life, but my father had to go through when those messages popped in on his WhatsApp. I mean, it's not the best of sight for a father to witness on his WhatsApp. Clearly, for no father in this country, ever, or anyone. I mean, I do not want this on any human life, but what is the country doing about it? Why has the UN been forced to intervene in something like this? Anand Kumar Hegde, who is now the skills minister in the government, has famously called me a jihadi in a tweet. This is the reward they're getting for abusing journalists, and they're being made ministers. So what, and then I'm being asked to expect justice from this government. For the last 10 years, I've been waiting just for justice from this government. I have only faced a great deal of backlash. I have been traumatized like perhaps very few have been. I know how difficult it is for me to have picked up the pieces from the last 3 weeks and even to be speaking here today on a television channel. It's been a difficult, traumatic journey for me. And this is, I mean, it can happen to me. Imagine journalists in rural areas who have absolutely no support, a journalist who have no logistics, who have no, I mean, nothing. A common person who is abused day in, day out. If they're so brazen, they can do it to journalists who have a name, who have a reach. Imagine the plight of people who do not have the reach. When I went to the police station to file my complaint, the cop asks me, why didn't you go to the police station where you first checked the tweet, where you first opened your Twitter account? Go to that jurisdiction. This is when there are 7 police officers and I'm showing them pornographic clips. Can you imagine how humiliating it is for a person?
No, that's outrageous.
And then we ask these questions, go to a police station where you first opened a tweet. This insensitivity is all pervasive. It's all over the country.
Rana, one moment, I'll come back to you and Ravish.
My entire timeline,
I'll come back to you, Rana.
Inundated with members who claim to be from the VHP.
We've got time. I'm not running away, but there are people who are calling in.
Muslims, they gang raped Muslims during 1947 partition.
Rana, this is it's
there's only so much that a person can
do. We have the second caller.
Cross the threshold.
All right, we've got a couple of callers. Do we have the callers? All right. We've got 2 callers who are actually listening in on this call. Mr. Pradeep Bhavnani, go ahead with your question or your brief comment.
Hello, Mr. Ravish Kumar and Madam Ranak, I hope. I don't give any attention to them. You know, they are only talking about the Chappan Ka Chhati of Modi. They are kayar log, they are kayar. Geethi log hai. और आप उनके ऊपर बिल्कुल ध्यान मत दीजिए और आप आपका जो कर्तव्य है वो करते रहिए. आपने जो जो भी इम्पार्शल जो भी आपने न्यूज दी है उसके लिए मेरी पूरी सपोर्ट आपको है, पूरी दिलो जान से सपोर्ट है. और मैं भी एनजीओ का प्रेसिडेंट हूँ. और रवेश जी, आपको मैं बता देना चाहता हूँ, ये कायम लोग हिंदी लोगों से आप डरिए मत. ये बीजेपी है ना, ये इफ यू कैनॉट कन्विंस अ पर्सन कन्फ्यूज हिम, ये वाली पार्टी है. मैं 45 साल ये पार्टी में रहा हूँ, 45 साल. बचपन में 8 साल का था जब मैं आरएसएस की शाखा लगाई थी.
Sir, let's focus. Let us focus on the threats to Ravish Kumar. I welcome the comments that you've mentioned over there, but I don't want this to be a broader political discourse. I'm trying to look at something very specific: threats to journalists, whether it's from the BJP or anywhere else. Ravi Bhatia, you have a comment. Go ahead.
हिंदुस्तान में किसी को मारने की इजाजत नहीं है. कोई भी हो, वो अपना काम कर रहा है. रवीश जी, राणा जी जो है अपना काम करते रहे, हम लोग उनके साथ हैं. और वो अपना कर्तव्य पूरा निभाए ताकि हम लोग को सही बात पता चलती रहे.
विकास सिंह, you know, the point that's been mentioned repeatedly is that, you know, there is an institution, it's nefarious, which exists, it's very widespread. Unless there is some sort of legislation from the government to stop the spread of hate in this manner, what can realistically be done? Because the point being mentioned is that, you know, there are journalists across this country who are extremely vulnerable. They don't have resources. They can't get big lawyers. The police doesn't necessarily support them. They are vulnerable. Whose responsibility is it to protect this institution from these awful threats?
Well, in this program, I saw some people mentioning that these people are followed by some important ministers, etc., and they have not defriended them. I feel that this is a time has come when, you know, these ministers, I don't know whether they are seeing it themselves or not, but somebody in their office should analyze all these handles or Twitter handles or whatever social media platform where they are personally present. And if they find something offending, then their office should lodge a complaint. I mean, that would set an example, and that would really show to the people that the government means business and the government will not tolerate this kind of intolerance towards people, you know, respect coming up with a different view. Because I totally agree that if a central minister is following somebody, and if in spite of following him he takes no action, then this person gets emboldened as if he has a backing of you know, that particular minister or that particular dignitary. So there should be a system put in place. Also, there should be these kind of cases should be given to some kind of a central agency which can, you know, look into these IT related cases specifically. So some task force could be created,
right,
with experts on, you know, technology who can look into these cases, because ultimately these are to trace a particular call or to trace a pattern which is coming in this social media platform, on various social media platforms, requires a lot of technological, you know, sort of inquiry.
Okay.
And that inquiry needs to be done. And the moment we have at the governmental level being serious that this kind of a thing has to stop, then I'm sure a message will go down the line and people will not, you know, ever think that they're doing something to please the political bosses. Okay. And unless that is done, it will be very difficult. I agree with you. Very difficult for every journalist to fight his own case,
right,
and to, you know, run after lawyers and to spend that kind of money.
Yes.
And in the process, he or she gets diverted from his, you know, normal work.
That, in fact, is my next question.
Instead of doing your normal work of being a journalist.
Ravish,
yes, you will be running around.
No, it's impossible. For years in court. But Mr. Singh, I just wanted to go back to Ravish. As a television journalist, it's your job to be away from the studio and on the road. Now, you are followed all over. People, you know, I mean, I've called you up from all sorts of parts of the country where people want to speak to you because they see I'm in NDTV. They want to talk to me. They want to talk to Ravish Kumar. people in China. I was there a few weeks back. I want to talk to Ravish Kumar. I said, I don't know him. Talk to me. but being serious, it's not possible for you to be out on the field if there is a threat, a physical threat that lies on a roadside. You cannot, as a journalist, be independent if you have security guards next to you or the police protecting you. So this, in a way, comes in the way of basic journalism. That's pounding the footpath.
बहुत मुश्किल है मेरे काम करने का जो तरीका है. मैं जिंदा तो लोगों के बीच रहता हूँ और ये कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि उन्हीं लोगों के बीच में ना जा पाऊँ. और ये एक पैटर्न डिमोनेटाइजेशन के समय मैंने देखा कि मैं कहीं भी जाता हूँ तो व्हाट्सएप से एक मैसेज होता है, फिर 10-20-50 लोग आके मुझे घेर लेते हैं या फिर किसी का बाइट लेता हूँ तो कहते हैं आपने इनको पैसा दे के एंटी मोदी बाइट बोलने के लिए बोला है. वो साधारण सा आदमी होता है, दबाव आ जाता है. तो एक कोशिश होती है कि जब मैं फील्ड में कैमरा लेके जाऊं तो एक क्राउड को वो खड़ा कर दे. हर जगह हम पुलिस और उसको लेके नहीं जाते. अच्छी बात है कि लोग सपोर्ट करने वाले हैं. खासकर देखिए राणा को कितनी तकलीफ हो रही है. शर्म आनी चाहिए लोगों को कि एक इस तरह जाबाज पत्रकार को इस तरह की स्थिति से गुजरनी पड़ रही है. लेकिन ये कोशिश यही है कि आप पत्रकार ना रहें, आप वो गोदी मीडिया जो मैं बोलता हूँ साहब का गुणगान करते रहें 24 घंटा, तो कोई दिक्कत नहीं है आपको. लेकिन अगर आप सवाल करने के लिए कहीं पहुंच गए हैं तो इनको बहुत दिक्कत है और ये पॉलिटिकल कल्चर बना दिया गया. इसीलिए मैं कह रहा हूं कि दिल्ली के पर्सपेक्टिव से आप देख रहे हैं विष्णु की इन पे ध्यान नहीं देना चाहिए. कोई ध्यानवान देता नहीं मैं इनपे. लेकिन आपका फोन अगर 10 दिन से अगर दिन रात बजता रहो आप फोन की तरफ तो देखेंगे तो नजर आता है. लेकिन हुआ यह है कि छोटे छोटे शहरों में जो नौजवान लड़के हैं जिनको अपॉइंटमेंट लेटर देना चाहिए था उसकी जगह उन्होंने ये जहर का लेटर दे दिया है कि तुम इसको पढ़ो रटो और वैसे लोगों के पीछे पड़ जाओ जो जिनको ये ब्रांड करते हैं एंटी हिंदू और ये सब. तो जर्नलिज्म को, टीवी जर्नलिज्म वैसे ही खत्म हो गया है. हम और आप जो कुछ लोग फील्ड में जाना चाहते हैं अब ये हर समय तो एसपीजी लेके तो नहीं जाएंगे ना कि आप उस जगह को सैनिटाइज कर दो रवीश कुमार आ रहा शूट करने के लिए. तो ये इनके फेवर में काम करता है कि फील्ड की रियालिटी नहीं आएगी. थैंकफुली लोग मुझे इसी नंबर से, जैसे हरदोई रेलवे स्टेशन पर पानी नहीं है, शाहजहांपुर बरेली में पानी नहीं है, तो मुझे कैसे पता है. जो यात्री चल रहा है वो मुझे फोन करके वीडियो बनाकर भेजता और मैं उसको दिखा देता हूं. जैसे मुझे पता है कि हमारे मंत्री पुशअप कर रहे हैं लेकिन 100 नौजवान 10 महीने से नौकरी का अपॉइंटमेंट लेटर के लिए भटक रहे हैं, तो वो मुझे कैसे पता.
सो द सेम फोन व्हिच यू गेट थ्रेट्स आर फोन्स वेरी वेरी इन द सेम फोन वेयर यू गेट मैसेजेस व्हिच यू कैन ब्रॉडकास्ट. ओके, वी आर नाउ 138th in the world in the press freedom index. This is,
we must do push-ups in our newsroom.
It is
because our INB ministers is promoting push-ups. So every journalist and editor first must start doing push-ups in newsroom because India has achieved 138 positions in regard of press freedom
so
in the world.
So our press freedom index is 138th in the world. This is a shameful statistic. We lie beneath countries, I'm told, like Afghanistan and other countries as well. We like to think that we are better than other countries. This is something that is patently not the case. We've got a couple of phone calls as well. Go ahead, Johar from Jalandhar. Go ahead with your short comment or question. Go ahead with your question. All right, I don't think we've got that line at the moment. Ejaz, I'll just go back to you. You know, you've seen all of the comments, you've seen everything that is being said, and the one point that in Godi constantly threatening this institution in this country, are we not essentially being divided between two? Those who actually ask questions and those who give the answers to questions which they have been fed.
No, it's, obviously it's absolutely condemnable what is happening to certain journalists in this country. Well, it is condemnable because you are entitled to have your opinion. But listen, Vishnu, it's not only happening now. I mean, I know my own father's case in 57 where he was put behind bars 3 times because he opposed the government of the day. And he had to fight his own cases. And thankfully, those days, the cases used to be decided much earlier. And he got justice from the Supreme Court finally. So we've had this situation. But obviously, hate crimes, death threats, murder threats, these are all culpable, these are all cognizable offenses which the police must act on, because you cannot you cannot have a situation where somebody who's trying to do his job is at the receiving end and is unable to function as a normal human being because of these various threats. So there's something needs to be done, and it's incumbent on the law and the police mechanism that they take cognizance of all these things under relevant sections and take action by doing thorough investigations where the technology is required, and also talk to Twitter, Facebook, wherever, or WhatsApp, wherever such things are being used to work with them, to come out with a mechanism where you can identify these people and put a stop to such hate spreading further.
But can I just raise the basic question of why doesn't the government stop funding and sponsoring them? Why doesn't the Prime Minister unfollow them? Why don't the ministers unfollow them? Why don't they wind up this operation of hate? If something happens to Ravish Kumar tomorrow, to Rana Ayub, who's going to be responsible? I'd really like to know that.
Piyush Goyal ko tweet kiya hai ki aap itne itne troll ko aap follow karte hain.
Piyush Goyal follows some 70,000 people.
Look, I think what we've tried to do on this program is just to highlight the extent of the threats and the nature of the threats. It's not just people disagreeing with what Ravish or Rana or Swati or anybody actually tweets on a particular issue. It's gone to a level where it's life and death. And if
exactly.
you don't believe that it's life and death, and if you believe that, you know, we are exaggerating, let me end this program with a couple of names. Gauri Lankesh, murdered on the 5th of September 2017. Naveen Nischal, murdered on the 25th of March 2018. Rajesh Mishra, murdered on the 21st of October 2017. Sandeep Sharma, murdered on the 26th of March 2018. Shantanu Bhaumik, killed during a dangerous assignment on the 20th of September 2017. Sudeep Datta Bhaumik, 21st of November 2017, murdered. These are a few people who've laid their lives in the altar of journalism. That's what this is all about. But these are the real threats which continue to happen. Thank you very much for being with us. Goodbye.
Thank you.
दादी कहती थी कि स्पेशल